Students, we are learning about agriculture in India. In our second chapter, that means agriculture second chapter, we are learning the food crops. Yesterday we learned about rice and today we will learn about wheat. Wheat is a temperate grass. That's why it cultivates in the temperate regions of India. That means the places which located in the north, means northern plains from Punjab to Bihar. This region have a cool climate in the winter season, and some part of the Deccan Plateau also have the cool climate. So these regions cultivating variety of wheat crop. So wheat, it is rich in proteins, vitamins and carbohydrates, which provides a balanced diet. That's why nowadays it become more popular in the southern part of India also. That means in tropical region also people consuming the wheat because of its nutritious value. Okay, we can see which are the important climatic requirements for the cultivation of wheat. So as I told earlier, wheat requires cool climate, moist climate during its growing period. But when it ripens and reaches to the harvesting season, it requires a warm and a dry climate with abundant sunshine. So this climate is available in northern part of India, means it experiences a cool climate from November onwards, and by the end of February the temperature increases. So suitable temperature for the sowing period as well as the harvesting period is available in the northern plains. What is the temperature condition required for the wheat cultivation? The sowing period, it needs a range of temperature between 10 degrees Celsius to 15 degrees Celsius, that is during sowing period. And around harvesting period, it require 20 to 25 degrees Celsius temperature with the abundant sunshine. Then only it will be turned into a golden and a brittle color. Then high heat and excessive rainfall is not suitable for the wheat crop. So high heat that leads to the drying up of the wheat crop, excessive fall rainfall that leads to the decaying of the wheat crop. Okay, so this type of climate is experiencing in the tropical regions of India. That's why in West Bengal or other southern peninsular states not cultivating the wheat crop, because those region experiencing a tropical climate with the high temperature and heavy rainfall. In northern plains also, in Punjab and northern part of Deccan Plateau, it cultivates only in the winter season. Then the amount of rainfall suitable for the cultivation of wheat crop, that is between 50 to 100 centimeter. On an average, we can say 80 centimeter of rainfall. As you know, in the northern plains, especially Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh and all, western disturbances bringing winter rainfall to those regions. So this winter rainfall, it gives enough amount of rain water for the ideal growth of the wheat crop. Then sometimes the occurrence of frost at the flowering time, then the occurrence of hailstorm at the time of ripening, that can lead to damage of the wheat crop. Okay, so the climatic conditions that hinders the growth of wheat, that is high temperature, excessive rainfall, then frost at the time of flowering and hailstorm at the time of ripening. These conditions are not suited for the growth of wheat. Then the soil condition. So wheat, as it not require much amount of water, it can grow with the help of irrigation. It does not depend on the rainfall. And wheat cultivating regions have perennial rivers and enough irrigation facilities also available. And wheat require a well-drained soil. So the alluvial soil or loamy soil, which is well-drained, that is suitable for the cultivation of wheat. And in the peninsular region, northern parts of Deccan Plateau, the wheat is cultivating even in the clayey loams, which are well-drained. Here, methods of cultivation. It follows broadcasting, dibbling and drilling methods. About these methods of cultivation, we have already discussed in the rice cultivation chapter. The harvesting, it takes place by the end of March. So here, the temperature condition that will rise about 20 degrees Celsius, and abundant sunshine is also available in the ripening time or maturity time of the wheat, and it can be harvested by the beginning of April, and by the golden brittle color we can understand the harvesting time of the wheat crop. So the average temperature for the harvesting period, it is 25 degrees Celsius. It can go up 27.5 degrees Celsius, but it is going above that is harmful for the wheat crop. The largest producer of wheat in India, that is Uttar Pradesh, the state of Uttar Pradesh. And Uttar Pradesh, Punjab, Haryana, these states together named as Granary of India because they produces the largest amount of wheat in India. So this part, they got the name Granary of India because of the Green Revolution only that multiplied the crop productivity in the northern plains. Other important states for the cultivation of wheat are Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh. Now, millets. Millets are the small grains or the inferior grains, which include a number of grains which names, some names only we are learning, jowar, bajra and ragi. So they have some local names like jowar, sorghum or cholam, bajra, kombu, ragi. All these are local names using in the local languages of each states. What is its importance? It serve as food grains of poorer sections of the society. These millets, they have a cheap rate only, but it's a cultivation that is decreasing because the millet cultivating regions are now transforming into the cash crop cultivating regions. So here these millets, they are drought resistant plants. They are able to withstand in high temperature and low rainfall. So it cultivate in such areas where rainfall is less. So in such region we know that the people will be poorer. That's why it is said that serves as the food grains of poor section of the society. This is having high nutritious value. So nowadays the other parts of India, means those who are having wheat or rice, they are also using millets because of its nutritional value. Okay, then the straw of this crop, that is a valuable fodder for the animals. In the wheat cultivating and rice cultivating regions, millet generally do not cultivate because wheat and rice needs its special climatic and soil conditions. High quality soil is required. Then which regions not having these facilities, there only millets cultivating. There it serves as a fodder for the animals also. Then as I told earlier, millets are hardy, drought and heat resistant plants. So they are cultivated in the drier parts of the monsoon land, interiors of the Deccan Plateau, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, even Rajasthan also. In Gujarat, the northern parts of Gujarat and all, these millets are cultivating. So the important crop, jowar, that is a garif and rabi crop. In both the season, jowar can cultivate. So that is an inferior grain. And Maharashtra is the largest producer of jowar. Maharashtra, that state, is the largest producer of jowar. So here, temperature condition that we no need to study in a correct pattern. Just keep in mind, it can cultivate in between the temperature of 20 to 32 degree Celsius. 20 to 32 degree Celsius. And the rainfall, that also, for all the millets, we can study in this pattern. 20 to 100 centimeter rainfall. So the temperature from 20 to 32 degree Celsius and rainfall from 20 to 100 centimeter. Then soil condition, all the millet crops, they are cultivating in the inferior quality soil only. So it can be cultivated in the dry loams and in black soil, then in laterite soil or in red soil. Even in sandy soil also, these millets can be cultivated because they are resistant to such geographical conditions. That's why they are cultivating in those regions. So heavy to light alluvium or red soil or yellow loam, all these are suited for the cultivation of these crops. Then, as I told earlier, Maharashtra is the largest producer of jowar crop. Now, bajra. Bajra, it is a kharif crop. This crop is cultivating in the drier regions, but Rajasthan is the largest producer. Bajra, its largest producer is Rajasthan. That is a kharif crop, cultivating in relation with the monsoon rainfall. Where monsoon is unreliable, poorer, that region bajra is cultivating. Then you can see here the temperature condition. It is average temperature condition is 25 degrees Celsius. Rainfall amount is 100, and it can cultivate in the sandy loam or light soil. So Rajasthan is the largest producer of bajra. Now we can learn about ragi. It is also a kharif crop, and this kharif crop is cultivating in the southern regions of peninsular plateau. Karnataka is the largest producer of ragi. Karnataka largest producer of ragi. Then here also the temperature condition, you can see 20 to 30 degrees Celsius. Rainfall 50 to 100 degrees Celsius. It can cultivate in sandy and red laterite soil, loamy soil. Okay, so for the millets, you no need to study in a correct pattern. Average temperature 20 to 32 degrees Celsius. Rainfall 50 to 100 degree, sorry, 100 centimeter. Then sandy to loamy soil, the suited soil, sandy loams to alluvial soil or black soil, any type of soil it can cultivate. It is not compulsory, it can retain moisture, or it must be very well drained soil. It's not compulsory, because these crops are able to withstand in such condition. Even these crops are cultivating in the dry farming areas, because the red soil, laterite soil and all is used for dry farming, and in such regions millets are cultivating, because they does not require much irrigation water. Now the next food crops, these are pulses. Pulses are food grains. Pulses includes a large number of seeds, the grains like dal. In local languages it is named as dal, tur dal, urad dal, moong dal. Then many types of peas, many types of grams included within these pulses. So these are very important supplier of protein in the vegetarian diet. Very important supplier of protein in the vegetarian diet. So India is the largest producer and consumer of pulses in the world. India is the largest producer and consumer of pulses in the world, because in India there are a large number of population have the vegetarian diet, and these pulses, they are used for extracting oil also. Okay, some pulses they are used for extracting oil also. Then this is a leguminous plant. This leguminous plants, they are able to fix the atmospheric nitrogen in the soil, that will increase the fertility of the soil. So they are used as rotation crops. After the cultivation of rice or wheat, pulses are cultivating, and that will enrich the fertility of the soil. And next season, rice or wheat is cultivating. So these pulses are rotation crops. Then the average temperature required for the cultivation of these pulses is 20 degrees Celsius to 25 degrees Celsius. 20 degrees Celsius to 25 degrees Celsius. Then the rainfall amount, 50 centimeter to 75 centimeter. 50 centimeter to 75 centimeter. And the suitable soil condition, dry light soil is required for the cultivation of pulses. So the light soil or the well drained soil, that is alluvial soil, that is used for the cultivation. And even black loamy soil, black drained, well drained soil, or red soil, laterite soil, all these can be used because they are light. So when it is having light texture, this soil is suitable for the cultivation. It depends on the area, means the terrain of the area. So you can find the different types of dals that we are using in our daily life. We are using these different types of dal in our daily dishes. Without a dal, we cannot imagine sambar, our sambar. Then without a dal, black gram, we cannot imagine dosa. So like that, some dishes we are making with the help of these different types of dals only. So the important producers or cultivators of pulses, that is Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan and Maharashtra. Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan and Maharashtra are the important cultivators of pulses. Okay, that is about the food crops of India. So we have learned about the rice, wheat, millets and pulses. So you have to go through the exercise and try to find the answers. Which answers you are not getting, that mark in the textbook and send its photo through WhatsApp. Okay, have a nice day.